Hello, everyone. All right. We're going to go see Queen Nefirta. She's on the next floor up. All right. My dear saviors, you have returned. And how are things in the shrine? I hope that... Wait, that key. It's the royal key, ancient heirloom of my line. The great treasure is one of the two priceless gifts that King Hadid is said to have bequeathed to the desert. The other being the legend of the saviors, of course. The tales passed down from one monarch to another tell that it is to be used to open a sealed door within the likeness of the Great Spirit, but only when the time is right. Now you have been guided to it, almost as if by the hand of the King Hadid himself. The time is surely upon us. You must go to the likeness and open the door. I'm certain that behind the century-sealed portal lies the means by which the desert may be saved. Okay, how do we get to the likeness? Party members are no help. Okay. You recall, I was unable to get there because there was no path. Surely. There's a way. Oh, you know what? I think there is a way. Oh, it's bloody hands. Maribel defeated all but two. Anyway. Let's head back over to town there and use the inn and save our game, because it's been a bit since we've done either of those things. But if you remember, there's a teleportal that we saw there inside the pot. I think that one takes us to the shrine. If I remember correctly. Indeed, you've joined our saviors. Might this mean that we're to be saved once again? Forgive me, I must not tempt fate. Allow me to simply offer you a bed for the night. Though, of course, I cannot allow you to take shelter in here without paying the going rate. It is a business I operate, not a charity, after all. Fucker. Alright, let's do this. Aha! We did it. We have made it to the Spirit of the Great Likeness. Your journey here to visit the Likeness must be the most arduous journey. However, the Spirit of the Land confers his protection upon all who cross the desert. Pray for a safe journey, and the Great Spirit is sure to oblige. Great Spirit, please, use your all-seeing eyes to drive the evil monsters from our beloved sand. I hear the likeness doesn't look much like the Spirit himself. It only shows the form he takes when he's just ready for battle. So come on, Great Spirit, get yourself in battle mode and do something about these horrible monsters. Please, I'm begging you. Almighty Spirit of the Land, please deliver the desert from darkness. Spirit of the Land, Great Protector, please. Take your rightful place within the likeness and guide the desert into the light. We desert dwellers are counting on you. You are our final hope. Welcome to the likeness of the Great Spirit, my traveling friends. The Spirit of the Land takes many guises, as it is said. The likeness depicts but one of these. The guise of the Great Spirit is readiness to do battle with monstrous foes. I travel the world so I can spread the good word of the Almighty. It can be a tough sell at times, especially since all our prayers have brought little in the way of salvation. I simply cannot understand it. My apologies, you are not permitted to proceed any... Oh, you are in possession of the royal key! In the time of which he who rebuilt the likeness spoke, it has come at last. Unlock the door, which has stood unopened for so many centuries. Unlock it and go forth. Cesar uses the royal key. The door creaks and slowly opens. Cesar, the carvings on the slabs of the floor, they must surely be of significance. We must examine them more closely. Cesar examines the area around his feet. A mysterious message has been carved into the floor. Two eyes who shine through the darkness. A mysterious message has been carved into the floor. A mouth sealed so tight that only time will open it. Two ears born from the same heart. A mysterious message carved into the floor. A nose to search high and low, very low indeed, for secrets. Intriguing. I must note down these words. There, I've recorded the details of all the inscriptions. If you wish to be reminded of them, you need only ask. Come, we must continue on our way. I love the music in this area. I don't know why, but it reminds me of Earthbound. Hey, a mimic heart. I already got a whole bunch of those, though. Through the cave, north. And it looks like an upside down pyramid? Possibly a rhombus? Let's go this way. Yes, it's a dead end. Perfect. Just like I imagine a real pyramid would be. Oh, bloody bloater. Hello, Emperor Jewel Slime. Vile creature. Dingbat. So far, we're not seeing any new monsters. I did catch a dingbat while doing some job leveling last night for my monster meadows. I think I caught a terror hawk as well. Quite the winding path they're sending me on, though. The torch burning inside the coffin. Close the lid? No, not yet. See if there's anything in here. It is becoming slightly darker. With only one torch, so it should be significantly darker. The room is plunged into total darkness. Oh, what is this? Some eye stones! Excellent. Did it. Oh, they all opened up again. That was an interestingly simple puzzle. Oh, shit. Hey, Ash's gladiator level increases. Ash attains the rank of heavyweight, learns multi-slice. Hey, what's this? The gold finally gets up and looks over unexpectedly. Yeah, head over to the monster medals, buddy. Okay, she hasn't mastered it yet. Close! This is a dead end up there, but I want to see if there's a treasure chest. God damn it. Ran right into that. Defeated. Alright. Do like treasure. And there is none in there. Alright. This way leads to a dead end, but again, might be treasure. Nope, no treasure. Alright, so that is leading me to areas that don't have treasure. Let's try Golden Frilling. Hey, did you know every day is misery? I don't know about that. A huge statue of a terrifying monster's face blocks the way. Okay, that's not where I use these? Alright. That's not where we go yet then. You're new. Demon Deacons. Even the demon deacons run from me. Let's go this way first. What is up these stairs? Ah, heart-shaped gemstone. So we got eyes. We got the heart stone. Thank you. Now we need ears and nose. Eyes, ears, mouth, and nose. Well, the ears would be the heart, right? Because that's what they said. Triangular gemstone, okay. A nose stone, okay, cool. Did Hadid build this place too? No wonder it took him so long to put the likeness back together if he was building all this at the same time. How did they build this massive building all the way down here? I can't get my head around it. I think I'm missing one of the stones, though. Guess we'll find out. Shit. Fuck you, dingbat. Jumping my way like that. See you later. Down. Is there another path over here, maybe? Oh, you know what, actually? They said something about the heart stone, so let's examine that. Little gemstone shaped like a heart. It cracks down in the middle of it. It looks like it could easily be broken down into two. Break the stone in two? Yeah, see, they said the heart becomes the ear, right? Yeah. Oh, that's weird. It's a mouth stone. That's weird. I think that's all we gotta do. Let's see. Slimes, please be real and love me. I don't know about that one, Trig. Can I evac? That's the question. So much quicker. Save some time here. I can. Excellent. Alright, so apparently I gotta go back and talk to the old man, I believe. Okay, there we go. Let's get out of here. Gotta climb out of the pot. Man. See if this will spark his memory a bit. So you have returned, By the sands. The face of the great spirit. You've gathered together the parts with which it must be depicted. Please, you must give them to me at once.
Oh wait, that's the device I use from.
Now watch closely, for you will not see such a sight again. Spirit of the land, sleeper of the sands, the time has come at last. Here is your depiction, here is your invitation, here is your awakening. Hear the call of your people in their hour of need. Guide them into the light. Great spirit, awaken from your slumber and join your children in this, your home.
That looks nothing like the order that you place those in. This looks like a Mega Man boss. Looks very upset.
By the sands! This is... Who dares rouse me from my slumber of so many years? So it was you. You who recited the incantation. You who reassembled my scattered form. You have shown wisdom and courage in your abundance. In return, I shall grant any wish that you so choose. What is it that you desire? What would you have me do? Speak.
Sesei tells the Earth Spirit about everything that's happened.
So you have need of we spirits, and the world has need of you. Very well. But first I must see to it that my people are protected. It is done. The desert dwellers will suffer no longer. However, as you know, I cannot restore this island to the world. Not alone. Such a feat can be performed only when all four great spirits have joined forces. Only then will the desert be truly saved. You and you alone can reunite us, and I have faith that you will. Until that time, I will await you at the place called Altrian's Abbey. If you require my assistance before then, you must make use of this.
Sorry, takes the Earth Amulet.
Return to the world and continue your quest. Your work here is done. The desert dwellers are under my protection now. Go forth and do not fail us.
I sense the evil oppression of the land has lifted somewhat.
The spirit of the land in the flesh is almost beyond believing. Thank you, Sesei. Without you, I would never witness such wonders.
The desert is safe now. The power of the Great Spirit protection. Or perhaps it is your power. In any case, my work is done. I must return to Albalat. Farewell. My back. Curse these aged bones.
It seems I must help our old friend home.
We will go on ahead to Albalat. You must go to the Temple Palace and tell Her Majesty of all that has occurred. I'm sure she will be eager for the news. Farewell for now.
Alright, let's go talk to the queen.
It is great relief to see you safe and well, and you were able to awaken the spirit of the land from its slumber. Praise be to the saviors of the sands. Your efforts on our behalf have driven the monstrous hordes from this palace. And this, of course, is not the first time. We desert dwellers owe you our very existence on behalf of all of us, of this generation and all those that came before it. I offer you our undying thanks. Alas, ordeal is not over yet. Not all the monsters have been driven out, and the desert remains shrouded in darkness. It seems even the great spirit of the land's great powers will not suffice to save us, at least not alone. We face a powerful evil indeed. But you mean to confront it nonetheless, do you not? I fear I could do little to assist you, save pray for your success. But pray I shall, each and every moment of each and every day. As will all here in the Temple Palace, and all in Elbalad. We look forward to re-welcoming you next time as savior, as not just of the desert, but of the whole world.
Alright. Well, I think next on the list... Let's go upstairs. So, let's go back to the shrine. Interesting. Well, let's go back to the sea dragon, I guess. Still though, doing pretty good.
Ahoy there, so sorry we've been waiting for you. The spirits you've awakened, those of fire, earth, and wind, they've been making their presence felt here aboard. You'd best come with me, lad. Captain Sharkai, Sasori, and his crew have returned. Aha, then time has come at last. Come closer, lad. Ah, it is the moment we've been waiting for. The glowing orbs that circle the ship must surely be representing the great spirits you've awoken. Raise the sea saber, serpent saber cap, Sasori, call them to me. Sasori holds the sea serpent blade, a saber aloft. Yaha! Our course is clear, Mr. Tar. Prepare to weigh anchor. We follow this light wherever it may lead. Aye, aye, Captain. Hold the anchor, lads, where you sail for glory. But of course, Captain Rainbow Cove is just the, as the spirit, water spirit said. Behold, lend the sword.
I am the water spirit. For many centuries, I have slept, but I have always watched over you. Watched and waited for this day, the day when your light would shine upon me at last.
Brave heroes, in waking me, you have succeeded in your task. The four great spirits sleep no longer. And now it is time for us to combine our powers to free these lands from darkness and make our world whole once more.
Hear me, Sasare. The lands that were plunged into darkness have been restored, but our work and yours is not yet done. The Almighty must be questioned. We must know why he, from those whose very essence we were formed, would condemn our lands to banishment. Before we depart, a gift.
Sasare receives the water amulet. Sasare places the water amulet in bag. Now come, we will lead the way.
Almighty One, Heavenly Father, heed our call. The power that plunged our realms into darkness, that banished us from this world, it was yours, was it not? We may draw only one conclusion from this, that you are not the Almighty at all.
So it is you who dare disturb me with such blasphemies. You will come to regret your words. I am the Almighty, there is no other. This world needs no other. I am the one true God. Only I can answer the prayers of humankind. Only I can bring joy and prosperity. Your kind are no longer wanted, no longer needed. It is better that you were disposed of. Do not resist your fate. There is nothing to fear. You who have slept so long need only embrace the darkness once more.
How dare you! How dare you defy the Almighty! My body, it... How very amusing! It seems you are not quite the pathetic servant of a broken god that I took you to be. But this changes little. I had grown tired of my little game long before you meddling worms arrived. You were foolish to expend all your energies in unmasking me. Now all that stands in my way are a handful of pathetic humans and the wizened old lapdogs of the Almighty. I stand unmatched and unopposed!
Well, that's a thrilling looking place.
Theopont! That was a close call indeed! Well, friends, art thou still among the living? Our situation is woeful beyond measure. Though I had lost faith in he who ruled over us, I could never have imagined this true identity to be that of the Demon King himself. I yearn to scale this evil edifice and chase down the black-hearted fiend. But alas, there is no question of reaching its entrance unaided. Come, let us away to Estad and avail ourselves of the Sky Stone. Cesare, I have been expecting you. It would seem we have no respite. No sooner had we begun to celebrate our return from the darkness than the Almighty was revealed to be none other than the Demon King in disguise. I take it you had a hand in the uncovering of this great betrayal? I suspected as much. You have saved us once again. Truly, we owe you and your companions a debt beyond measure. We must call on your aid one last time. Please, I ask that you not only as a king, but as a citizen of a world in terror, you must rid us of the Demon King once and for all. Only when the supreme evil has been defeated may peace truly return and the... I hate to interrupt, but I'm really, really worried about my pants. Sorry, but I have to go and check on them. I'll leave the Demon King stuff to you, Lot, for the moment. I'm sure you'll be fine. Bye.
Where was I? Ah, yes, the Demon King. As you know, they're no doubt aware, his capacity for evil knows no bounds. But you must find a way to defeat him. You are our only hope.
Alright. There's a few things I want to check while I'm here. How do I get to where I need to go? So if you recall, there's this thing here.
Yeah, I remember that.
There we go. Wait, what's going on there? I've got a bad feeling about this. Alright. So I should be able to zoom. Zoom for Buckingham. Pretty sure this is where I gotta go.
So remember, we were looking for the people of Haven, right?
Well, I'm very close. and I don't want to finish the game before I do this, because... I think I checked the lighthouse last time, so let's check here. Aha!
Whoa, where did that wretched boy go? He's a prince! His people need him! I simply refuse to believe he has shirked his responsibilities and run away. Excuse me for asking, but you wouldn't happen to have seen a prince by the name of Flemreek in your travels, would you? Tell him where Flemreek can be found. Are you serious? He slipped out to live a half-built backwater somewhere? Does he really think I'm going to allow such a thing? I'm gooing there to make him get him the right this instant. But before I goo, my name is Gulio. Who's to know whether we shall meet again, but I know that you have my gratitude.
That's hilarious.
Haven.
Did this world change again? It looks like it did. Okay, that's awesome. Yeah, another mini medal.
Is that our king over there, or is this the other king?
This is Tyke from Squex. This is down there. I don't think my village has improved at all. I don't think so. Well, maybe. Strength ring. Another mini medal. All right. Thank you. another king over here? No, that wasn't a king. Alright.
Flimmerick! Thank goodness, I finally found you! Now, let's not waste any more slime here. We're going back home to the castle.
No, please, I don't want to go back. I live here now.
What are you talking about? Do you really think I'm going to allow such a thing?
Who's to say I care if you allow it or not? I'm staying here and that's that.
But why? That's what's so great about this odd little backwater.
This odd little backwater has given me something I've never oozed to have. Freedom.
Freedom? But you are going to be emperor. You have no need for freedom. You have an empire to rule and a duty to fulfill. It's high slime you realize that you will have no need for freedom.
No. It's high slime you realize that I just can't do that. Father, please. If you lived here for a while, you'd get used to it, and you'd be surprised at how goo freedom tastes.
You always were a jelly-headed dreamer, Flimmerick. Father!
Very well, if you insist, I'll give it a goo. I will stay in this town for a while and see what it is that's got you so excited.
He is a slime.
But Father...
But I warn you, as soon as I satisfy myself with that this freedom of yours is just oozeless nonsense, you and I are going straight back to the castle. Now, you there. Who's the one who told me about my empty-headed brother in the first place? Though his future concerns me, I must say, this is the first time I've ever seen him so happy. And for that, you deserve a reward.
The Uzantium Tablet.
Well, Flamik, I suppose it is slime for you to show your father what this precious freedom of yours is all about.
Or ritual come things. Those could be good for Ruff. A suit of royal mail. This could also be good for one of my characters.
Ah, mysterious fragment. Excellent. But yes, he is a slime.
A malevolent lantern heart. Excellent. How do we get into the casino again? Down here? Another green one.
Ah, Metal King armor, Prison Peacock, Flail of Destruction, and Skimpy Nighty. This naughty little number is sure to turn heads wherever you go. Okay.
Better for Ruff. Ruff really can't equip Metal King armor. Oh, ice, it's better for you. Let's trade you. There you go. And...
Oh yeah, that's way better than what Ruff has.
Huge, huge bonus.
It's the slime to see you again.
Yes. Almost like sublime. What's the slime? I like it.
We're almost done for today. I just gotta go check on this tablet, and then we're gonna go to...
Byzantium. It has Gulio. Alright, we'll check this one out after. That said, we're gonna head out to the Metal King place and check and see what he has for me.
Greetings, I, King Maximo, have an undiminishable passion for mini-metals, which has gathered hither and thither throughout the world. Splendid, I see if you have mini-metals with you. Let me examine them, my friends. That takes the number of mini-metals you've given me to 92, Sasori. Congratulations, you've given me 83 mini-metals, which means I can administer a Sage's Stone to you as a reward. Congratulations, you've given me 85 mini-metals, which means I can administer a Mysterious Fragment to you as a reward. Congratulations, you've given me 90 mini-metals, which means I can administer a Metal King Shield to you as a reward. It seems I currently have 92 mini-metals for you in my dominion, Sasori. Once you brought me a total of 95 mini-metals, I'll be able to reward you with a Glomble Arrow. Alright. And... Metal King Shield. Let's give that to... Oh, Ruff, you can actually use that, huh? Yeah, we'll give it to Ruff. We're going to All Trades Abbey. We shall pick our characters' next jobs before we're done for today. Alright. It seems the Demonkin was one of the ones everything today. I know it's all to ask, but I believe that you can defeat the great evil. The great spirits gave you their blessings and their amulets. You have been chosen. Sasori, you're a golem right now. You can be a... Let's see, what can't you be? You cannot be a pirate, a hero, or a gladiator. One. Two. That's all these. Okay, three will be well-wisher. Already mastered that one, already mastered that one. Four will be malevolantern. Five lips. Six walking dead. Seven drake slime. Eight jaw toys. And berserker. So we're gonna roll eight. Two. Alright, so Sasori is gonna be priest next, which is good because we haven't actually mastered that for him and we need to. That'll be quick though, I'll probably finish that tonight. There we go. Aish will probably be before the others. So Aish cannot be a priest, which is like the one thing she hasn't mastered on that. But we do have access to one. Two. Three. Four. Five. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 10. Yep, they do. 5. Alright. So, 1,
to... Three, four,
five. Drake slime. All right. Where are you? Your next one will be Drake slime, which I should be able to again finish that tonight. Okay. Mervin cannot be a priest or a Drake Slime, but I think he's already mastered priest. No, he hasn't. Alright, so one for martial artist. Two, three, four, five. Six. No, wait. Yeah, I got that one. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. Yeah, so you get to roll out a nine. Four. Okay. So one, two, three. Are gonna be a slime. Yay, Mervin. The greatest of honors. And lastly, Roth. Roth's already mastered all those, but he can be a gladiator, one. Monster Masher, two. For King Fuchsia, four for Malevolent Lantern, wait, no, four for Seasaur, three for Seasaur, four for King Fuchsia, five for Malevolent Lantern, six for Mimic, seven for Chimera, eight for Heal Slime. Ten for Goodie Bag. Okay, let's do this. Slime to meet you, yes. Two. So he's gonna be... One. Two, Monster Masher. Which is good, because then I can go get some Mandrake Majors easily. Alright, so I'll probably master some of these tonight. We shall see. But yeah, sorry for the extra long stream, but I'm not sorry for that. But I had fun, we got past that part. We're on to the end boss here. There's a side quest I might want to do beforehand that I remember reading about. I gotta look into it though, maybe I can't do it yet. 3 for the Golem Vocation, 22 for Hero, 45 for Gladiator, 18 for Pirate. Anyway, so there's some stuff I'm going to look into. I'm also going to play some slots tonight, get myself some Metal King armor probably. Mervin's already done Heal Slime. He's just going to be Slime. So I'm going to get myself some Metal King armor for my characters, some other stuff possibly through coins. That said, everyone, thank you for viewing. Tomorrow we'll be back with more Dragon Quest VII. Like I said, we got some side quests to do that I want to finish, and then possibly going to beat the final dungeon. So everyone, thank you very much for viewing. Have a good one. We'll see you tomorrow.